हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सौरभ पटवर्धन फ्रॉम नंदादीप आई हॉस्पिटल पीजी टीचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट सांगली महाराष्ट्र इंडिया, एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी स्पीकिंग अबाउट अ केस ऑफ स्यूडो एक्सफोलिएशन विथ सीवियर जोन्युलर वीकनेस एंड फेकोडोनेसिस, एंड इन दिस केस व्हाट इज द थॉट प्रोसेस ऑफ द सर्जन. सो दिस इज अ पेशेंट 75 ईयर ओल्ड जेंटलमैन विथ अ वेरी एडवांस्ड स्यूडो एक्सफोलिएटिव ग्लोकोमा. And as you can see, my colleague is operating here, and as the attempt to make a capsulorhexis is done, you can find that the bag is quite unstable and there is phacodonesis. There is no counter traction provided by the zonules, making the process of capsulorhexis a bit tough. Now at this point, the surgeon has to judge the zonular strength. So does the bag have enough zonular support, and considering it is a progressive pathology that it's going to increase over a period of time, what should be the treatment options? So the surgeon here is trying to complete the capsulorhexis, and a small capsulorhexis could be done. Of course we have to enlarge it. So after making a tangential nick, we can enlarge this capsulorhexis, but still we have to think here what should be the strategy to tackle this kind of weak zonules. So after completing the capsulorhexis, the colleague decided to call me, so I thought that let me try using a capsular tension ring to stabilize the bag and see how it goes. So when you decide to put a CTR in the bag, we are committing to the fact that we want to preserve this bag. So when I start pushing this CTR into the bag, you can see the zonular weakness is quite significant, and I can see the edge of the lens bag coming and getting pulled in the pupillary space. So I think this is a warning for me that the zonules are quite weak and the CTR is not going to be sufficient for the stability, and even if I am able to do the phaco, it's not going to be stable later. So I have one option here to use the capsular hooks, do phaco, put CTR and then CT segment or double CONE for scleral fixation. We have to fix both sides of this kind of bag for the stability over long term. It's going to be a tedious procedure. And second option is going to be do the scleral tunnel, remove the nucleus, remove the bag, do antivitrectomy and put a scleral fixated and iris claw IOL, which is going to stay stable for a long period of time. So here, considering the age of the patient and the pathology, I decided to go ahead with the option number 2. And every cataract surgeon should know how to make a good scleral tunnel. Here there is a corneal incision, but if you make an incision in the sclera which dips just before the corneal incision's entry into the anterior chamber, it doesn't make any trouble. So that's a big scleral tunnel. I don't want any resistance from the scleral tunnel here, and because the capsulorhexis is smaller in size, I'm going to do capsulotomy, giving some radial nicks so that nucleus can be mobilized from the bag. And this is the best method for cases where zonules are weak. So we use two Sinskys to pull out the nucleus. Use ample amount of dispersive OVD in such cases to protect the endothelium, also to separate the nucleus from the bag. So create space beneath the nucleus, and then I'm going to use Sinsky to pull this nucleus out from the pupil, which is also significantly rigid considering it's a case of pseudo exfoliation. And now I'm going to do visco expression. So I'm going to push the dispersive OVD under the nucleus. You can see my cannula here, and simultaneously I have to press the posterior lip of the scleral tunnel, so the nucleus gets engaged in the scleral tunnel and we can express it out. So this is a very important movement. You can watch it again and again. Common mistake done is not pressing the posterior lip of the scleral tunnel and the nucleus gets stuck. So I'm going to use time slone to just look for the vitreous, but since I did the nucleus removal quite meticulously. There is no vitreous prolapse during the procedure, but I am going to remove this bag in toto along with the cortex because I don't want the capsular bag, which is not stabilized, to stay there, because it is going to crumple and then come into the center in the later postoperative period and can cause visual problems. So it's best to just remove this bag in toto using a good vitrectomy probe with high cut rate and low vacuum. Once the vitrectomy is done, all vitreous cleared, I'm going to use intracameral myocol to constrict the pupil, and now getting ready for the iris claw IOL implantation. This is another technique that every cataract surgeon should know, how to place an iris claw IOL. So I'm going to put it retropupillary. There is an area of iridectomy, so I'm going to avoid that. This is the iris claw holding forceps, and then the claw goes behind the iris and then it is enclaved using the 27 gauge cannula. On the right side, I am going to use Sinsky hook because of the rigid pupil. I want to negotiate this IOL behind the iris, and once it is there, what I am going to do is pull the iris claw IOL a little bit anteriorly so I can see the claws or impression of the claws, and then I use the Sinsky to enclave this iris claw IOL. So nicely enclaved iris claw, you can see those nice dimples on the iris. I'm going to do further vitrectomy to remove any anti-vitreous if present, and particularly remove all the OVD which has gone in the vitreous cavity during iris claw IOL implantation, because this is a case of glaucoma. I don't want any IOP rise. I'm securing the scleral tunnel, though it is already stable. Make sure the anterior chamber is watertight. I don't want any hypotony in the post-operative period, and I'm going to use the autologous blood. In fact, it's just the blood which has trickled down from the sclera to just fix this conjunctiva. So this is like the suture-like closure of the conjunctiva. This is the post-operative picture 4 hours after the surgery. Quite a good outcome despite the difficulties during the surgery. For more such videos, do subscribe to my YouTube channel. And how you will tackle such a case if it comes on your surgical table, do write in the comment section. Thank you.